How's it going, Tyler?
Shut up.
What's wrong? What's wrong?
What are you doing?
Working on my calc. Got a test coming up.
You need to learn how to do calc. Don't you already know how to use a calculator?
Wait. Calculus, not calculator.
Calculus. Is that even a word? I'm pretty sure you just...
It's a word right here, buddy. Let me show you. Calculus.
You could have just made that up. What's AP calculus anyway?
AP calculus. It's a class. You're too dumb for it.
There's a class with two letters in it.
Two letters in the word, yeah.
You mean like my AP stat class?
Yeah. You poor, stupid idiot.
Call me stupid, kid.
Stupid idiot.
You even learning anyway?
Derivatives and integrals and... integrals and non-infinite series. I'm not in BC. Not that crazy. You want to learn?
BC? Can't you just stick with app?
You want to learn or not?
I don't want to learn jack. I don't even know what you're doing.
Well, I'll show you. You want me to show you?
Amusement.
We got y equals 1/2 x here. Are you paying attention?
Should I be?
Yeah, come up here. So you have y equals 1/2 x. You know y, right?
Yeah, y's right there.
No, I'm saying you know y. This is y equals 1/2 x, right? This is the line here. Y, that's the equation for the line. You know.
Oh, y is the line?
No. As x increases by 1, y is going up by half a block. That makes sense, right?
Yeah. I learned this, Ethan. Teach me something.
All right.
No!
I know, Mr. AP Stat. We got you. All right, so take the derivative of this. You're going to do y prime equals 1/2. Because each time x goes up by 1, y is going up by 1/2. That makes sense, right?
No. Why is x there and x, like,
x
disappears?
Because you're taking the derivative. As you
What's
have
a derivative?
That's the rate of change of an equation.
You mean a derivative?
A derivative.
That's how Mrs. Bowers says it.
No, Mrs. Bowers does everything wrong, okay? You gotta become a disciple of Turner.
Turner?
Mr. Turner.
Sounds like a cow.
You'll learn one day. Alright, so... Every time it goes up by 1, it's going up by 1/2 of a block. That means that your derivative is 1/2, because each time you're going up by 1, you're going up by 1/2 a block.
So you're telling me, instead of saying change, we have to say derivative?
You can say rate of change. It's the same thing.
Then why don't they just call it that?
Don't ask me. I'm not the one who created it.
Then who did?
We must go back.
Ha! Don't even... No. Everyone take your seats. All right, good. All right, guys. So most of calc, as you guys already know, is made up of derivatives and integrals. Derivatives are the slope, integrals being the area under the curve. They're opposites of each other. One takes it forward, one takes it backwards. But as in calc, we like to make things a lot harder just for you, Dalton. See, we also do this thing called trig. I'm gonna pound this into your brains right here. You see, we got standard functions like sine x, cosine x, tangent x. The non-fun ones. Alright, so as we know, as we learned in pre-calc, probably stat, because they teach you the easy stuff. We have sine x, the derivative of sine x is cosine x, the derivative of cosine x is negative sine x. But what's the derivative of tangent x? The correct answer is, as of now, nobody knows. Probably none of you care, but I'm gonna teach you how to derive this by hand. Yeah, the cool stuff. But before that, we also need to take in hand the inverses. We have secant x, cosecant x, and cotangent x. All of these have derivatives too, and these are even more fun. Alright? Alright, so let's start with the first one we don't know, tangent x. You first start by tangent x by...
Oh my god, this is so boring. When am I gonna learn something useful? Wait a minute. I think I can fix this. Let's see what happens if I divert his attention to the immediate left.
Hey, Mr. Turner, look over there!
What? Cows? Where?
Oh my god!
I didn't write that. Alright, who wrote this? No, seriously, who wrote this? Did one of you guys do something while my back was turned? I'm pretty sure I didn't write that. I mean, Jesus Christ, you scared the marker out of my hand, but... I mean, it's right, so... I probably wrote that. Probably. Alright, well, I guess I explained this one. So, let's talk about the derivative of secant x, and maybe I can, I'll explain this one to you guys. So, to start with the derivative of
secant... Let's do this one more time.
Hey, Turner, look over there. There's a real cow.
Bertha, come back. Bertha! Gonna stop lying to me, Dalton. Come on. What are you doing? No. I did not write that this time. I did not. I know what I wrote. This was not here. I don't even know if that's right. Okay, maybe it is. But. I know I did not. Where's my work? There's gotta be... Alright. Well, you guys know the rule. Well, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna create a little chart for you, and then we can just work from that, and you guys can copy that down into your notes, and you got it.
Hold on, Mr. Turner. I got a better idea.
Oh, yeah? Show me. Hey, that's not school appropriate. That has nothing to do with cows. So, but wait a minute, that's creative. I like that. I get, cause the tan, and then the sex, and then the squared, and like, and the sexy people. And you guys are so ahead of me, it's not even funny. You guys are gonna do better on this AP exam than I am, but
still didn't write that.
Alright. You're actually on a hidden camera show called The Calculus Effect. I'm Dalton Slizol. We like to go around and play some funny math and magic jokes on people.
You gotta be kidding.
Nope.
You're telling me this is magic?
Yep.
It's not magic, it's math.
Go. Let's go, guys.
Side so you can get in. What's the integral of 5 to the x?
5 to the x over natural log of 5.
Alright, this kid's actually not that bad like Sam. Alright, he took like a minute to solve it. Alright, what's the derivative of sine of x times cosine x?
Sine x cosine x? It'd be sine cosine x. Cosine x plus sine x plus cosine x plus sine x. Sine x cosine x plus cosine x sine x.
There you go.
Sorry about that.
What a chance
that
was here.
Wow.
He's an academic too.
Clap, give him a clap, yeah.
I have a cookie for you. Alright, what's the derivative of 5 to the x raised to the fifth power?
If you're stupid.
I know I should know that. Alright, I didn't learn much in your class. What's a derivative?
Derivative?
Yeah.
Well, it's the slope of a graph at a particular point, or the equation for the slope of a graph at a particular point.
I might have actually learned that once or twice. Yeah, what's an integral?
An integral?
Yeah.
An integral is something that's really, really important.
Really?
Or it's the area under a curve. Or it's both.
It's important? That's like an actual definition? I didn't know that. Can I ask you something for our talk project?
Yeah, sure.
All right. So, on your entrance exam for the Penn State, how often did you get to use calculus on it? Zero. Seems to Turner, this is all a waste of time. We don't need it for anything, all right?
Mr. Turner, I like your class. Don't fail me.
Fail him.
Go now.
Since you're an academic, we'll start you off easy. What's the root of x squared?
You'd like to know.
I would, yeah. That's why I'm asking the question. Yeah. You know. X squared.
I'm just going to mess that
x
up.
X squared?
Yeah.
Two x.
Oh, look at him.
I'm smart.
It's better than like half the kids so far.
Yeah, you're good.
All right, sorry to interrupt you for this project here, but we're going to ask you some questions for calc. So you're an academic calc, right?
Yes.
All right. Get out of here. We'll start you off easy then. What's the derivative of 3x squared?
6x.
Wow, look at this kid. He's smart like Nick. All right. What's the derivative of sine?
Cosine.
This kid's great. He should be an AP. All right. One more. What's the derivative of 5 to the x?
Rookie, man.
Come on, Kevin. Back on.
5 to the x over the natural log of 5. Plus a constant.
That's the integral.
You're
dumb. Oh, the integral? Oh. All right, so since you carry your calc class, we're going to ask you a few questions. What's a derivative?
It's like the thing where you put the thing in front of the other thing.
Then what's an integral?
Oh, it's the thing where the slippery snake is in front of the equation.
And you have the numbers there, right?
Yeah.
That little dx thing?
Yeah.
He's got it.
Represent.
In calc class?
Yeah.
That's tough. Alright, I'm gonna give you a redemption for your calc test. So, what's a derivative?
It's the rate of change on a line.
On a line?
Yes.
Alright, cool. And what's the integral?
The area under a curve.
I don't know how he failed this last test.
Neither do I.
I don't know how.
He's in our class.
I'm not in your class.
Go away.
How often on a daily basis do you use calc?
How often on a daily basis?
Or like how often would you use Calc?
Well, since I teach, I use it, I don't know, maybe 30% of the year in AP.
He would know, he's an AP.
And that's an AP class. That's 30%.
Yep.
You're failing it, right?
No.
That's your grade, right?
What is your grade in Calc?
85.
You an academic?
Yep.
That's why, guys.
He's funny sometimes. Turner's joke of the week.
Stat.
Turner's joke of the week.
Oh, what's up, Tyler?
I got some bad news.
What's your bad news, buddy?
I passed! Ah! Yeah!
No way! What'd
yes!
You get? What'd you get?
A 3! No way! I'm just getting a 5! I can count! Yes!
I saw your test. You got a 1.
That was before, man. Turner, he's a cool cat. He let me retake the test for free.
I don't think he can administer that.
Can he?